All right, well, let's get our bodies moving. We'll have our DJ pump something up, but give yourself a nice big shoulder roll. Shug them up to your ears and all the way down. So shrug up to those ears. Slide them down and back. Inhale up. Exhale around. And it's Monday, so let's just reset our posture. So sit up or stand up nice and tall. Pull those bellies in and up as much as you can. Allow those shoulders to drop down away from your ears. Maybe your arms down to the side.
Nicole, just keep me posted on if you want me to raise or lower volume. I can never tell when you're sharing the song.
Sounds good. Well, let's try it out and see. And we'll get some thumbs up from people or down. Either way. So sit up nice and tall. Drop those shoulders away from your ears. Maybe give them a few extra wiggles. Grow that spine on an inhale up. Exhale, let the shoulders drop, but keep that length. And then we're going to take our chins from this kind of forward position we often sit in. And we're going to grow that spine tall and pull your chins back. Parallel to the ground still, but you're getting those quadruple chins. And then release that. Again, sit up tall. You're going to squeeze the back of your neck to pull your chin back. Tighten it up. 2, 1, release, give it a little wiggle. And let's get going. So keep that tall posture, chins up, chins back. Put this down a little. All right, let's take it on a little run. Make it nice and big to start with. Bring it down. Get those knees going. Maybe just your heels up. If you're standing, like jog in place. Think tall posture here. Can you keep that tall posture you started the beginning of class with while you're moving? Pick that pace up just a little bit. Make sure you're working within what feels good for your body. So maybe that pace is just extending those fingers a little bit more and getting a little bit more active through, but you're still keeping a nice slower motion. All right. Maybe it's you're pumping faster. Whatever it is, your hardest, we're going to give our first little sprint here. We're going to do 3 of them. 10 seconds. Pick it up here. And your hardest, go. Push yourselves. Breathe. 2, 1, slow it back down. This is home base. So you could have a conversation. We'll come back here throughout class. Pick up that pace. Push it. 2, 1, go. Two, one, and slow it down. Home base. Awesome, you got one more just like that. In 3, 2, 1, push it. Three, two, one, grow tall, take up space, big star jacks. So taking up space, fingers extend out. Maybe step 1 foot out at a time. Maybe it's both feet hop. You're here for 3. And 1. Drop those arms down. Roll them. Big shoulder rolls. Awesome. Let's grab some weights or bands. We're going to start with bicep curls. So we're going to do some resistance, and then we'll go back to cardio. And we're going to go back and forth between those two things, right? So if you've got weights, thumbs up, elbows in, up for 10. Three, Last one. Drop those shoulders down. This time you're gonna roll your hands, if you can, palms up, bicep curls here. Elbows lock into your side and a little bit more on the shoulders, rotate out. Next rotation, but somewhere in here, palms up for 10. Three. One. Nice work. Come out in front of you. Palms face down. Come up. Same thing, just reverse. Working on the extension on those triceps. Two. One. Nice work. Stay here in the center. Roll those hands up and down, working those forearms, elbows lock in. You can do one at a time and put your arm on like a table or on your leg, but rotating those palms up and down. You don't need any weight for this, just you can just stretch them over. Just nice stretch, hold it, palm up when you get there. See if you can rotate a little bit further and hold two. One, come back into center. Shake it out, set that aside. Bands behind or weights. We're gonna go for a little cardio, little boxing. You can also do it without. I'm gonna put a band behind my back and we'll stay here for a moment. But get those arms going, punch it forward. Sit tall, stand tall. Breathe. Grow that tall posture, chins back, rotate. You can have a nice wide stance and tuck those hips around with you. Chest goes. Three. Two. One. Pause here, drop those shoulders down, arms out wide. Push it forward, slow, both arms. Two. One, release that. Give yourself a wiggle, maybe a sip of water. Shake it out. We're gonna go through that series one more time. How's everyone feeling? Doing all right? See some smiles? All right, here we go. Punch it forward. Whatever speed and force you want to put through those arms, but make it purposeful. Push, push, push. Exhale. Cross through. Two, one, arms out wide, push it forward. Maybe a little different angle this time, push up a little higher. Awesome, looking strong. Two, one, nice work. Release that, take it back down into home base. Catch your breath, grab a sip of water if you need to. But keep moving. So even when you get a sip of water, try to like keep that body moving in some way. All right. Keep it going. You got one little sprint here. So pick up that pace. Three, two, one. Whatever your hardest looks like, go for it. Push yourselves. Whew. Mom, you're halfway there. Three. Slow it back down, home base. Awesome, drop those shoulders away from your ears. Exhale. Now you're going to your right by your hips, where your pockets would be. Thumbs up, and we're going to come up active and wise. So fingers are super extended if you don't have weight. Or you can do some light resistance here and add some weights in your hands. Up and down. Nice and slow and controlled. Up, pause, control it down. Two. One. Arms come in front of you. Reaching up. Drop those shoulders. Three. Take breaks as you need. This is a little bit endurance on those shoulders. So if you need to shake out, stop and do it. Reset. Two. One. Bent arm T's. So we're coming out to your side, palms face down. Squeeze them back down. How's your posture? How's your breath? Two. One. Arms come down. Shake it out. Take it on a little jog here. Home base. We're going shoulder presses next. Right. Here we go. So find some resistance. You can do bands or weights. And we're going to go up in goalpost arms, wrists super straight. If you look down at your shoulders, you could see your elbows. So they're not going to be back behind you. They're right in line with your shoulders or maybe slightly in front. There we go. Here we go. Push it up. You can do, we always do one arm at a time. Two. One. Nice work. Release that. Shake it out. Palms face in front of you. And we're going to do upright rows right in front of your chest. So flat back, wherever you're at, upright row. So elbows come out to the side. Double check those wrists, make sure they're straight. Two. One. Nice work. Wiggle out those fingers, shake it out. You got one more set just like that. Shoulder presses and then upright rows. So find your challenge here. Sit tall, stand tall. Goalpost arms. If you want to add, you can add in a squeeze at the top. So you're going wide to narrow. Anyone wants an added extra challenge and you're on like a surface, you can do it. You can always add in the crunch and do a little sit up with it as you come up. Two. One. Nice work. Drop those arms down. Give yourself a little shoulder roll. Release it out, dance it out. Palms face you, upright row. Wide stances are always nice. If you're standing, maybe in like a wide squat and up. Sumo squat. Keep it going. You can always do two hands on one weight too, is another option. Two. One. Awesome. Take up some space. A little cardio here at Star Jacks. Step it out. Two. Rows are next. And one, release, shake that out. So I like to do rows with the bands, but you can do weights too. You're gonna hinge forward. The bands can be underneath your feet. And you're gonna squeeze those shoulder blades back. You can also keep it out in front of you. Close to wide grasp. So narrow and then pull wide. Or lock it under your feet or chair. Pull those arms back. If you're getting in legs, you're doing this in a lunge. So split stance. Squeeze those shoulder blades. Arms drive straight back. Two, hold the next one up. Just try to tuck those elbows back a little further. Squeeze those shoulder blades a little bit more. Hold and slowly release that back. Nice work. Catch your breath, wiggle it out. You got another set here. Change up your angle a little bit more. So reach out in front of you a little further. Squeeze. Or release it from your feet, arms here. Here we go for 10. Toss in some single arms here. Hold it back. Five on one side. Two to the center. Hold back, five on the other. Awesome. Two to center. Hold the last one back. Squeeze. Two. One. Release that down. Shake it out. Home base here. How's everyone doing? All right. You got one sprint, push yourselves, two, one. Check that posture, breathe. You're here for five. Slow it back down. Nice work. All right, you're going opposite knee. So we're gonna stay on one side. So we're going opposite knee, opposite elbow. So you're gonna reach up to one side and then pull down to your other side. So you're gonna reach up to your right and pull left. Right to left. Squeezing. You can keep your arms wide and just tuck an elbow too. The idea is you're giving yourself a little squeeze. So you can also squeeze up with one leg, reach, pull. Added challenge would be with the weight. Pull some resistance. You're here for three. And one, hold center, like you're holding a ball or squeezing a weight. Tuck those elbows and just rotate side to side. Add a challenge just to find that balance point and hinge back, maybe lift one foot and then the other. Stay center, two, one. Nice work. Find that center position, reach left, pull right. Whew. Awesome. Keep it going for three. Nice work. Roll those shoulders. Come center. We're going to find that balance point one more time. So maybe it's hinging back with a nice flat back. Maybe it's just going to be sitting tall, and then as we lift your arms, that's where your balance gets challenged, right? Wherever you're at, fire up those abs. Pull your belly buttons as much as you can in, up to your ribs. Drop those shoulders down away from your ears. Inhale through your nose. Exhale. On your next inhale, prep your arms to lift. Exhale, raise your arms halfway. Nice. Find that balance point. Hold. Pull it in. Press it forward. Three. Hold your next one out. Challenge your balance a little bit more. Find a little higher. Pull it in. Maybe lift a toe. Two. And one. Find that center point and hold for three. Two. One. Release that down. Shake it out. Nice work. All right, you got one more little sprint here, so come back to home base. You got your last one, so start picking up that pace. Breathe. Start pushing yourselves. Always can have resistance. Push yourselves here. Sprints in three, two, one. Go. Three. Last two. One. Slow it back down. Big inhale and exhale. Nice work. Drop those shoulders away from your ears. Make some bigger moves. Stretch it out. Active recovery here. And then open up your arms. Give them a big stretch open. If you rotate your palms up, it gives you even a deeper stretch if that feels good to you. Drop those shoulders. So we're going to work on our finger extensors, strengthening the opposite motion that you do all day. We always grasp. So we're going to work on extending. So you're going to straighten out your arms. Maybe it's one at a time. You're going to pull those wrists back as far as you can. And I'm going to hold my arms up high, but you can always keep your arms down lower if that feels better to you as we go. Super active. Stretch those fingers as much as you can. Extend them. And then spread them open wide. Squeeze them together. Open. Super, super wide. Squeeze. Hold them open. Take your pinky. Squish a blueberry between your pinky and thumb. And then extend them out really wide. Squeeze. Extend. Once on each, twice on each finger. Hold. Take a break or reset if you need to. Half claws here. Always lower your arms. So just half squeezing. Two. One. One more here. Hold those fingers together. Pull them back as much as you can. Then go palms down. Pull your wrists back up. Three. Hold up. Open three more times, really wide. Extend those fingers as much as you can. Squeeze them. Open. Shake it off. How's everyone doing with those? A little different? I call them burners. So it starts to burn your forearms a little. But super important because we all grip so much all day. So find that nice tall posture one last time. We'll end the class here. All reverse motions. So shoulders reach up and slide them down. Grow that spine on an inhale. Exhale. Big inhale up, arms up overhead, reach tall. Exhale, keep that length. On your next exhale, pull that chin back, squeeze the back of your neck. Two, one, release. Nice work, everyone. But yeah, those extensions, those posture exercises, super great to recorrect everything that we do here all day, typing, pushing chairs, living life. So reopen and then work those finger extensors, makes your grip so much stronger too. So nice work, everyone.